So you want me just to speak into this right here? Okay, perfect. I'm Dr. Cole, and I'm the excavations director here for the TRA. And if you're watching this, this means that you are about to enter in to our excavation site in beautiful Cairo, Egypt. This is a historic moment. And so if you're watching the screens, you should see a hologram, a schematic of the site pop up somewhere around here so you can get an idea of what you're walking into. But it's going to be incredible. I'm sure this is going to be a routine dig, a routine excavation. It's going to be super calm, super clean, and I'm sure nothing could possibly go wrong. So I'll see you in there. All right, I'm good. That's perfect.
Are you there? You there? Great. Okay, listen. Our researchers thought that the Double Dog Champions Cup had been lost for decades. Until recently, we stumbled upon its resting place in a hidden temple under the streets of Cairo, Egypt. Only problem is, we don't know how to get it out. After you solved the mystery last year, we knew exactly who we had to turn to in order to retrieve the artifact from the lost temple and get it back into the hands of the TRA. Transit, you're our only hope.
Oh man, is that it?
I think so.
Cole, I've heard about it,
but I've never seen it in person before.
That's it. We've been looking for it.
The Double Dog Champions Cup?
The Champions Cup.
There's no way it's that easy,
There's
right?
There's no way. Do you think we can just take it?
There's no way. Maybe it's like a pressure plate.
I don't know.
Plate.
In all of our other adventures, it's always been a catch.
Maybe
I feel like
we swapped the weight out?
We should swap it out.
What do you think about this?
Yeah, I feel like that's good.
All right.
But I don't trust myself. I'm going to take it.
Okay.
You swap it.
All right. Count of three?
Yes, count of three.
All right.
Here we go. One, two, three. We did it.
We got it.
We got it.
Well, I guess
that was it.
We don't need anyone's help. I mean,
that's
this
as easy as it was.
Pretty
oh.
easy.
What's that?
I
Cole,
knew
do you
something
hear
like this was gonna happen.
Do
I feel
you hear that?
I feel something rumbling.
I don't know. What happened?
I don't know. Behind
what?
Us.
Turn around? What? Oh.
You triggered my trap! Now you must solve the cipher on the pillar before you if you want to leave with the Champions Cup!
The cipher will be solved once each of you determine the champions of each air.
With the cipher revealed, then and only then will you be able to leave with the legendary Champions Cup. The time is now!
The stage is set.
Beat the challenges!
Find the champion.
We Double Dog dare you!
Oh, oh, oh!
Welcome to Double Dog Dare!
Oh! Let's go!
Let's go!
Bryce,
let's go.
We have an adventure ahead of us.
Yes,
but
we do.
First, we need to know who is here.
We do.
Who's
here?
Roll
call.
Sixth grade, are you here?
Oh!
Sixth grade? Okay, it's not bad. That's
right.
Not bad.
What about my seventh graders?
That
here.
Was much better. I heard it, but
they're
I think that this group can do the best. Eighth grade, where are you at?
That's
not
good.
Bad. I heard him.
The eighth grade guys' voices are getting a little bit deeper, so
yeah,
it's harder
so
to hear.
It's harder to hear,
yeah,
but they're
yeah,
here.
Yeah,
they're
it's
here.
High pitch.
All right.
That's awesome. Good for you guys. Well, hey, just like the Double Dog head said, you guys competed in some challenges last night. Did you guys have fun? Yes.
How many of you didn't sleep last night?
How many
Show
of you didn't
how
sleep?
Many
Anybody
sleep?
Not sleep? Okay.
All right.
I didn't get any
we got
sleep.
A lot. Committed.
So we've got to complete some challenges.
We do.
Figure out
we
who
do.
Won the dares. Get the glyphs to figure out the cipher, and then maybe
and then we
make
get
our
here.
Way out.
All Fantastic.
Right.
Sounds
so
good to me.
So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna walk through a couple of our challenges from last night. The
Take
first
us off.
One, dare number one. Was the tallest hat stack on someone's head.
Tallest hat stack.
And we have three that we couldn't choose from. The first one is Adopt Me Peeps.
Adopt Me Peeps.
Adopt Me Peeps all the way on the left. The
all
one
right.
in the middle is Holy Moly Guacamole.
That's
I
a lot of hats.
One. And then the last one is Breaking Bread.
I like that name.
Breaking Bread.
Look at that. There's some commitment on here.
Is everybody here from those groups? Yes? Okay.
Yep. All right, I see them.
Here's the deal, though, Cole.
Yeah.
Because I want to play nice with the Double Dog Heads, and honestly, I can't choose between those three. You guys think you can decide for us?
I can make a decision for you.
Okay.
Now, those were a lot of hats.
They were.
But the most hats were from Adopt Me
Adopt Me Please, guys. Let's go.
That's right.
All right, so hey, here's what you need to do, and this is for everybody. If you win this morning, your entire group, go over to those double doors where Gene is, and you can collect your prize.
Double doors for the double dog.
Good job. Adopt Me Please. That was amazing.
Well, Bryce.
Oh, wait.
We have a glyph.
We get a glyph in order to help us figure out the cipher. What's the first one? Here we go.
Reveal the cipher.
It's a crow.
Cacool.
It's a crow. It's a crow.
Or an eagle.
That's the first. Or an eagle. Crow cool. or eagle.
It can work. Cool.
I don't know. I don't speak hieroglyph.
But we have one of many, and I think that we understand how this works now,
yes,
right?
Yes, we do. Let's keep
all
it
right.
going.
Let's keep it rolling. We have a second dare. The most cheese balls on a beard made of
shaving cream. Yep.
On a beard made of shaving cream, and our two challengers
The
grapes.
Where are you at, grapes?
Grapes. Let's go right there in the middle. And love and peace.
Love and peace.
Where are y'all at?
Where are you at? Love and peace.
Also over there. All right. Great. Look at this. Bryce, there's some dedication over here.
That's pretty good.
See, here's the thing, though. I think they got to this point because they had a lot of time.
Yes.
And so
time was on their side.
Yeah. And so what I want to see now is I would like to see them compete again, but in a little bit different of an environment. So I need two people from the Grapes and two people from Love and Peace to meet me up on stage
right
now.
Two people from each team. Come on up here.
We need two Grapes.
Two Grapes.
Two Grapes, come to the stage.
And we need Love and Peace. Here we go. All right. Two of you guys head down here. Come on over here to me.
What team are you guys from?
We're Team Grapes.
Team Grapes.
All right, so you guys are teams. Love and peace.
Here we go. So here's just how it's going to work. We're going to give you 1 minute, okay? And in that minute, you have to put a shaving cream beard, just like last night, on the other person's face.
Yep.
And then you have to get as many cheese balls stuck to their face as possible. The winner will take home some pretty epic prizes.
They will.
Right prize.
Epic.
So go ahead and decide who's going to put the shaving cream on the other person, okay? And then you have a minute, just like Cole said, to put the shaving cream on and the cheese balls on their face, and then we will finally pick a winner. Let me hear you make some noise for the Grapes.
Oh, oh. It's
not bad.
And what about for Love and Peace?
Oh.
Yeah!
Oh. Pretty good.
All right. I think we're ready.
You guys ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
All right, you guys ready to go? All right, let's count this thing off. Ready?
Three, two, one.
Let's go!
Oh, wow.
Getting right to work.
Oh, wow.
Man, what kind of technique are you using right now?
Spread it out.
Spread it out, all right. Man,
this is great.
There's a whole lot of shaving cream, but not a lot of it is on her face over here. It is.
Man.
Get that beard on.
This right here is great.
Great, yes.
Oh, she's throwing it at her face.
That's good, Bryce. That's good. Oh, you just ate one of them.
Oh, this is awesome.
Well, with the shaving
cream. It's more of a neck beard.
It's good.
Is it good?
But it's good.
Not good.
All right. How do you feel right now?
I don't know.
25 seconds left on the clock.
You got 20 seconds.
It is just
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
Wow.
They're really going for it over here. Love and peace.
15 seconds left.
Do you think? Okay,
what's
your strategy?
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Stop.
Enough. Put the cheese balls down.
Turn around.
Intense.
All right, let's look at Team Grapes.
It's still on. All right, so this is what we're going to do.
Team
we're gonna have you
peace.
Make noise for the team that you think won. These are two pretty good challengers. We'll do Grapes first. If you think the Team Grapes is our winner, make some noise.
Okay.
It's not bad.
It's pretty good.
It's not bad, Bryce.
What about for Team Love and Peace over here?
All right, Bryce. I think that we have a clear winner.
Yeah,
team
I think
Grapes
we do. Team
is
Grapes
winner.
Is the winner.
If
good job. Y'all both
over
though can
black
head
doors first
over
to get
there
your prize
to get cleaned up backstage.
Thank you for
go
playing.
Go ahead. You can get cleaned up over there, backstage, yeah. backstage.
Yeah.
There we go. Y'all make some noise for our contestants morning. That's amazing.
We're off to a good start.
That's a whole mess right there. That's
sure
a whole
is.
Mess.
It sure is.
All right. But guess what? Because we completed another challenge, we get another hieroglyph.
Let's see what it'll be this time.
Let's see.
What will it be?
Oh, it's beautiful. It's
a piece of fried chicken.
Or a fish
there we go.
Or something.
All right. Here we go. We're going to move on to dare number three.
Dare number three.
Most surface area covered by pennies.
Most surface area covered by pennies.
Again, we've got three.
Let's see what we're working with here.
Whoa.
Come
Whoa.
For life. K-A-H-M for life.
These are pretty good.
There's that one. This team and the fine apples.
The fine apples.
I like that.
Right.
That's a song.
Bryce, these
That's
are
pretty
intense.
Good.
They're pretty good.
That's pretty good.
I can't
they got
pick
the shapes.
I can't
on.
Pick. Wow. I think we got to keep them involved with the game today.
Yep.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you guys, so much.
Will you pick for us?
Oh, I'd be happy to.
Okay, great.
That was a lot of money. That was about my life savings, but
yeah.
If I had to pick one, the most surface area covered by pennies. K-A-H-M for life!
Congratulations! You can make your way over there to the doors to get your prize.
That's
Go
right.
ahead and head over there for your
Go
prize.
Go get your prize.
Good job, good job.
And Bryce,
y'all make some noise for them. That was great.
With another challenge meeting.
We get another hieroglyph. What is it? Here we go.
What will it be?
Oh!
It's a rat!
A horse with no legs.
It's a horse with no legs. We'll figure out what
it's
that
perfect.
Means later.
And this also means that we're a third of the way
we're
done.
We're a third
Look
of the
that.
Way through. That's
we're
great.
We're blazing through here. Time for our next challenge, Bryce.
Time for it. Let's go.
Best mid-air picture. Best mid-air picture. Here's our three finalists. Derek Zoolander.
Mava.
And Moo.
Moo.
And these are pretty good. Got some ballerina action going on over
That's
here.
That's pretty good. Here's what I think we should do, Cole.
Yeah.
I think we should get everybody in the audience on the count of three to jump up in midair, and I'll take a picture of you.
Okay? That's good.
Here we go. On the count of three, right. Everybody jump. One, two, three.
Do it.
I got it. Good job.
Perfect. Perfect.
Good job.
Amazing. Well, look, Bryce.
Yeah.
Here's the thing.
What?
Those were all pretty good.
They were.
And I don't feel like I can decide, but
Same.
I also think that these guys have had too much of an opinion.
I'm tired of hearing them talk.
Hey, fellas.
This time, we're going to put the power in your hands.
Hey.
Okay?
Hey, we're trying to talk here, gentlemen.
But I'm trying to talk.
We're trying to talk.
We're going to put the power in your hands.
Yeah, we are.
And we're going to let you guys make the most noise to see who the champion is with our patent-pending
Howl-o-meter.
Howl-o-meter. I apologize. My bad. All right. I need one person from Derek Zoolander, one person from Mava, and one person from Moo to join me up on stage. Y'all pick him and sit him up here.
One person from Derek Zoolander, one person from Mava, and one
Mava.
Person from Moo.
All right.
Here we go. Let's get who the teams are.
Who are you from?
Team Moo.
What's your team name?
My teammate is Madison.
No, what's your team name?
Oh, Mavea.
Mavea. We are not saying
that. And then
that
means that you're from what team?
Derek Zoolander.
What
led you to pick that name?
Because I can't turn left.
Okay, perfect. All right, so we're going to start off over here, and whoever makes the
That's
most noise.
That's a whole other puzzle to solve.
It
that
is.
Doesn't
we'll
make
figure
sense.
That one out later.
Okay.
Yeah, no, we'll
She brought a different cipher.
Different cipher, she brought her own. All right, whoever has the most noise on our Halloween will be our winner. Y'all ready? You have to give us your loudest howl. Okay?
Everybody on the count of three, give us a howl. One, two, three.
Let's do a practice
one. Oh!
That was good.
Perfect.
That was good. Get your vocal cords warmed up.
Oh, it seems to work.
If you think the team Moo did the best, let me hear you make some noise.
Pretty good.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
What about Team Mava?
And last but certainly not least, the directionally challenged Derek Zoolander. It's not bad. Bryce, what do you think?
According to our patent-pending howl-o-meter.
Our howl-o-meter.
Theirs. Sorry.
I feel like it's got to go to Derek Zoolander.
It's got to go to Derek
I think
Zoolander.
That's it.
Derek.
Good job,
Derek
Zoolander. Thanks for playing. Thanks for playing.
Derek.
Good job.
Derek.
Here we go.
Derek.
Y'all's whole team
Derek.
Can go ahead and head that way. Cole, with another challenge completed, means we get another hieroglyph. Let's see what it is.
We reveal the cipher.
Equal sign.
Two breadsticks.
Backslash. That's great. All right,
fantastic.
We're moving on to challenge number 5, Cole. The most interesting outfit / costume made out of
sticky notes. Oh, yeah. I really like this one.
All right. We have 2 finalists for this. The first one, Jesus lovers.
Whoa!
And then the second one, Las Chicas down
again.
Here in the front.
Oh, they're back.
See,
but here's the deal, Cole.
Look at the drip.
I feel like we need a challenge in order to make this happen.
I agree. I think that we need to settle this one a little bit differently.
I also agree.
And so I'm going to ask 2 people from each of these teams to meet us right down
meet
here
us
in
down
the middle
here
of the floor.
On the floor. Follow us. Here we go. Where are we at? We're over here, middle of the floor.
Make room.
Make way.
Going down to the floor. Right. Make some room,
fellas. Which team do we have over here?
Jesus lovers.
All right, where's my 2 for the Las Chicas?
That's a great name.
All right, fantastic.
Who you got over there, Cole?
I have the
Las Chicas.
Right with me.
All right. Did you guys have fun last night?
Yes.
What was your favorite challenge? They don't remember.
Too late. What's your favorite challenge?
The cheese balls one.
The cheese sticky balls.
Notes. Sticky notes. Okay, great.
The sticky notes. Yeah. You guys were finalists for the sticky notes. So that's great. All right. I'm going to go ahead and explain how this game works. Okay. You guys can go ahead and head over to this side of this square. So your team black, your team white. Basically, what's going to happen is you're going to have a minute. And in your minute, you have to flip as many of these tiles over to your the other color. You see, it's dual-sided, white side. So you're flipping from black to white, and you're flipping from white to black. The team that can flip as many as more over than the other team in a minute wins. Does that make sense? Yes? Las Chicas, you good?
Fantastic.
Jesus lovers, you good? All right.
You're trying to get as many white as possible. You're trying to get as many black as possible. You have a minute on the clock. Bryce, you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
All right,
three, two, one, go! Here we go.
Let's see it flip.
Here we go.
Flip it over.
Y'all are white. Yes, they are black. Y'all are white. Las Chicas are white.
The mayhem.
Here we go.
The
Y'all
chaos.
Are the black team. There we go.
Keep going.
All right.
Las Chicas are
Las
pretty
Chicas
dominant
are
right
dominating.
Now.
They're dominating.
30 seconds.
You're halfway there. Keep going.
30 seconds. If you think the Las Chicas are going to win, let me hear you make some noise. What about the Jesus lovers?
Jesus lovers are making a comeback.
Here we go. It looks pretty even. It looks pretty even. You got 13 seconds.
10 seconds to come down to anybody.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Stop. No more flipping. I think we have a clear winner.
I think it's pretty clear. I think the winner is Las Chicas.
Congratulations.
Boom. Y'all's whole team can make your
Las
way
Chicas.
Over to the doors.
And we'll
Good
make
job.
Our way
Excuse
back
me.
To the stage.
Excuse me. Well done, Excuse Las Chicas. Me. Great job. Cole, we completed another challenge, which
Man.
Means...
Oh, what's it going to be?
We get
what's
another clip.
It going to be?
Squiggly
oh,
lines.
Squiggly lines.
Yes.
I love it.
Yes.
I love it. Look, Bryce, that challenge right there was pretty tiring.
That was enough.
And when I get tired, I get pretty hungry, and nothing is more appetizing than this next challenge, which is the largest pile of finger or toenails.
Largest
oh,
pile
no.
of finger or toenails.
Yeah, but we have 3 fascinating
Yummy.
Finalists here. Du Bois.
Du Bois.
Du Bois.
Where you at, Du Bois?
Fantastic. Tired Coffee.
Tired
I think
coffee.
I'm gonna hurl it.
That doesn't make sense.
And Mochi Cat.
Mochi Cat, where you at?
I can't look.
And man, nice. Are these some great piles
Your dogs
right
are
here.
Dirty. You need to clean your dogs.
Yeah.
I mean, a fantastic collection. But Bryce, I can't make this call.
I can't either.
And so I
feel
think
like we gotta toss it back to our
friends. No,
no, no, no, brother, oh brother, this is gross. But I'm not a big fan of cats, but I do like mochi, so mochi cat win.
Mochi cat are the winners. Great job. You and your team can go ahead and head over to the doors to get your prize. Good job. That's pretty gross. Did that come from one person?
She's gone.
I hope not.
She's gone.
I hope not. That was disgusting. All right. We're on to our seventh challenge. Toilet paper mummy. Oh, I forgot. We get another glyph.
We must reveal.
A sideways D.
Patrick's house.
Patrick's house.
Fantastic.
Yes. This is good. Cole, we're almost there.
We're almost there.
Over halfway.
It's over halfway.
To getting back. All right. The seventh challenge was toilet paper mummy. Wrap an adult in toilet paper. We've got three contestants who are going to be battling
three pretty
it out.
Good ones, if you ask me, Bryce.
Hannah.
Whoa, look at those mummies.
Gingerbread and the transit onesies.
I really love the pink cowboy hat.
That's pretty good.
Does a lot.
Which was the leader in the pink cowgirl hat? Cowboy hat. Who was it? Are they here?
Y'all right there.
Cow person
nice.
Hat.
Fantastic.
I love it.
Fantastic. I love it.
Well, again, Cole, I don't feel like I can make this decision. So we're going to let the audience pick with our patent-pending howl-o-meter. So we need one person from each team to go ahead and make their way up to the stage.
Yep.
And we'll let the audience vote on which team
come on up.
Did the best.
Step right up. We want to hear you
what
howl.
Team are you from?
What
team are you from?
Canna.
Canna?
Nice.
We got the transit onesies
what
and the
you?
Gingerbread.
Transit onesies.
Transit onesies, and finally, that means you're from?
She brought a snack on
gingerbread.
Stage.
Gingerbread. Perfect.
All right.
Perfect.
So here we go. This round, I need 100% howls. So everybody on the count of three, give me your best howl. One,
let's
two,
practice.
Three.
That was great.
Not bad.
That was great.
Much better.
All right.
Much better.
So, Team Gingerbread. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
Okay.
All right.
What about down there with Team Canna?
Team Canna.
It's
not
all
bad.
Right. That was okay.
All right.
And then we'll come over here to the transit onesies. Let's do the two on the end real quick again. Gingerbread. It's pretty good.
All right. Not bad.
Okay. Team Canna. I gotta give it to Team Canna.
I do as well.
I gotta give it to Team Canna. Good job.
Team
you and your team
Canna.
Can go ahead and head over to those double doors over there to get your prize.
You know now it is time.
I know what it means,
you know
Cole.
What that means.
To reveal
we get
the
another
cipher. What will it be?
A pigeon!
A pigeon!
A pigeon!
Really long legs.
I love a pigeon.
I love it. I
all right,
it.
Cole.
Here we go.
This is it.
Moving on. We're making some good time.
We are.
We're going to get here pretty soon.
We
at this
are.
Rate. All right. Most impressive frozen waffle house or structure. Slash structure.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Our three finalists are 1-6 Bandits again.
1-6 Bandits.
Ooh.
Dense Faith. And the favorites, Las Chicas
Las
again.
Chicas.
Wow. With a Jenga tower.
Wow. This all looks
Chicas,
so
man,
good.
They were really
I
crushing it, I guess.
I mean, yeah.
Oh, I haven't eaten today.
There's some
with
creativity.
The Jenga.
Bryce, I'm torn. I cannot make this call.
And I feel like if we're going to get out of here, we've got to let them, like, boost their ego a little bit. You know?
I think so.
Yeah, I'll do it. Yeah. I'm happy to do it.
What do we got, Doghead?
Well, you know, those waffles all look delicious. I appreciate the Nutella that was put in that one, the Jenga, the functionality of it. But I have to give it the most creativity and the tastiest-looking Waffle House.
Okay.
To the Las Chicas!
Las Chicas!
Las Chicas!
Down here. Y'all can go ahead and head over there and get another prize.
Head over there. Get your prize.
Good job.
Muy bien.
Yo!
Bryce, we're
close.
We are close.
We get another one.
The next cipher.
A halo!
A portal!
A halo! Let me see your halo.
Bryce,
halo.
Sick. But we're moving along at a rate like this. I'm in a pretty good mood.
I'm in a pretty good mood. I feel good about where we're at.
We've been on a pretty great adventure together.
Have y'all had fun so far at Double Dog Dare?
Let's hear it. They have, and look, every great adventure needs some treasure.
Yeah,
and
true.
And so when you guys walked in this morning, you were handed raffle tickets.
Raffle ticket.
Going to give away some treasure of our own really fast.
Yes.
Let's go.
What is the treasure? What's the treasure, Cole?
Oh, wouldn't you like to know?
I would.
We're giving away a hoverboard go-kart.
A hoverboard go-kart.
It's the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. It plays music. It's got a speaker. It lights up. It's beautiful.
There it is.
Quite frankly.
Here it is. The hoverboard go-kart.
Held by the wonderful Kaylin.
I have one myself, Cole.
Do you really?
I ride it all throughout
the
Cairo.
Office? That's
and
amazing.
It's amazing.
I love
on
that.
The dunes. All right.
I love that.
So if you've got your raffle ticket, hold it up in the air.
Let's see.
And
him.
Wave it like you just don't care. There
perfect.
We go.
Perfect.
All right, Cole. Here we go.
All right.
I'm gonna pick one here. All right, I've got it. I'm gonna set this right here, in case someone lost theirs and this is theirs. All right, so here's what we're gonna do.
Yep.
I'm gonna call out a number.
Okay.
And if you've got the number, I need you to howl. So everyone, practice howling. 1, 2, 3. Okay.
Not
good.
Bad.
Good.
Not
and
bad.
If you do not have that number on your ticket, I need you to sit down. Cool. You got me. All right.
Got it.
Here we go.
Great.
The first number on our ticket is an 8.
Ow!
Pretty good.
Okay. The second number on our ticket is a 2.
Not bad.
The third number is a 9.
Perfect.
The fourth number, 4.
4, Gwinnett.
Everybody throw your 4s up.
A lot of people still in.
The fifth number, 9.
Oh, I didn't hear a lot of howls right
there.
A lot of people got out there.
I didn't hear a lot of howls.
Oh,
all right,
only a few people left.
Sixth number. What do you need it to be? It's a 0.
Did anyone get it?
I got to hear your howl.
Howl 0.
For me, brother.
There it is.
Oh, yeah.
And then the last number for the hovercraft.
For the hovercraft.
And if you win, I need to
it's
hear
not
you
hovercraft.
Howl. Okay. The last number is a 6.
Let's go.
She did it.
That's
she
good.
Howled.
That's good.
All right. You get the hovercraft. You can go ahead and make your way over there.
Bryce,
I just realized something.
It's time for our final challenge.
It is.
It is.
There was only
but
8.
I don't.
So 1, 2,
we did
3,
eight challenges.
4, 5, 6, 7.
But there's 9
8.
Parts to this cipher.
How are we going to get out?
You
I don't
need
know.
One more.
Well, how do we find it? All right, well, they're not going to tell
know.
Us. We're going to have to figure this thing
we
out.
We're
going to
talk about it, Cole.
Stand to your feet.
Go ahead. Stand
make
up.
Your way up to the front of the stage.
Come on.
We're going to worship together. Me and Bryce are going to go figure this thing
let's
out.
Let's
we'll
go.
See in a
we'll
bit.
Be back. Double Dog Dare.
Transit, are you guys ready to worship? Come on, put your hands up in the air. Here at Transit, we believe that Jesus is our Savior. He's the Son of God. And come on, let's worship Him. Let's go all in. Sing this out.
If living's got its options, find me on the side that's all in. If faith requires actions,
yeah.
Even if it's blind, I'm going to every question. You are what I believe.
Yeah, hands up!
So wherever you're going, God, that's where I wanna be.
We lift it up!
You dare me to move where I can't see. Ready to do what used to scare me. Faith is a step into eternity. If you want it, say you're all in. Dare me to move where I can't see. Ready to do what used to scare me. Faith is,
you guys ready?
questions begin. Chain reaction.
Chain reaction.
All it takes is one spark to spread. To every question. Wherever you go, that's where I want to be.
Come on!
You dare me to move where I can't see. Ready to do what you so scared me. This is a step into eternity. If you want him, sir! You dare me to move.
Transit! It's a little sleepy right now. So I want everybody from the front to the back. Let's get ready to jump. Here, one!
If you want it, if you want it, if you want it,
let's shout it.
Say, I believe it, and I receive it, and I believe in you.
Come on, take it up.
Put your hands up.
Come on, Transit. Sing it out.
I give you my attention, all my focus, pushing off the limits. In this moment, I feel your spirit moving all around me, coming hot your way. I'm picking up the dry bones, you reviving this faith inside of my soul. Dog Dare Transit. Hey, we love you guys so much. Y'all can take a couple steps back and have a seat.
Darathon. It has been a crazy, crazy morning. Would you guys agree with that? Yeah, I mean, I think you can just tell by looking at all the cheese balls up here that got smashed into our carpet, which is great. But the dare started last night. You completed those, submitted those in, won some prizes, played some games, and it has just been a crazy adventure, right? How would you, by the way, how would you describe adventure to someone? How would you describe that to someone?
Scary.
It's scary? Adventure can be sometimes scary. Yeah, yeah. What else? Crazy? Trying something new, okay? A journey. That's right. An adventure is something that is like unusual or it's a brand new experience. And the adventure that you guys are currently on is middle school, right? Middle school is an adventure. Now, some of you guys have been in middle school for a while, and so you've been on this adventure for a while. Some of you are actually transitioning, getting close to transitioning off of middle school and into a brand new adventure. But some of you are experiencing middle school for the very first time, or this is your first year experiencing middle school. But do you guys remember what an adventure it was on your very first day walking into middle school? Can you imagine that? Maybe some of you were a little bit nervous. Maybe some of you were excited. Maybe some of you just had kind of like mixed feelings, but you had like thoughts and ideas and plans for what middle school could possibly look like. All of these possibilities of what your middle school adventure could look like. And maybe for some of you, it felt a little bit like this.
The bestowing of chrysanthemums indicates familial attachment and by implication, affection. She must have left a message. Our future is up to us. What future?
There are two paths you can take, Enola. Yours, or the path others choose for you.
Our future is up to us.
Our future is up to us, yeah. I mean, that's such an amazing way to think about any adventure, any new thing that you're going through or experiencing, that man, all sorts of possibilities are out there and available for us. It's so encouraging and awesome to think about, like, yeah, it's up to us to plan out like what this life could look like. Right? And especially in middle school, you're going to be experiencing new things. You're going to make some new friends. You're going to do all of these brand new and unique and different things. And it's so exciting to think about and all to plan out and ideate and all of these things. But you know this, and I know this, and you've seen this in movies, and you've read this in books, that things can go wrong on an adventure.
Thank you.
Okay, so hopefully you're not being like chased down by this giant boulder in your middle school hallways, or you're being surrounded by angry native tribes, right? But things don't always go as planned, right? I mean, think about like elementary school. It's like, oh my gosh, it's so easy in elementary school. I don't need to study. I don't need to do all these things. But middle school, it just gets a little bit more hard, right? It gets a little bit more difficult in middle school. And so you're like, oh my gosh, I have to like study a little bit more. I have to actually do my homework and do my projects. I have to read a little bit more every night. Like this is a little bit difficult, right? Or from elementary school to middle school, people change. You guys ever experienced that? People change through middle school and high school, and those friends that you had in elementary school, and they were your best friends, they kind of change and become a little bit different. Or friends get mad at you in middle school, and you're like, I have no idea what happened. I thought we were going to be friends forever. Or maybe at home, situation at home isn't that great. Your parents lose a job, and so finances are a little bit tight. Or your parents are arguing, and they're talking about maybe getting a divorce. Or maybe even someone you love passes away. Life gets difficult. There are complications in life. And on any adventure, things can go wrong. And you're like, but I had all these plans. I had all these hopes and ideas of what middle school was gonna be like. And maybe if I just do all of these things, if I read more, if I respect other people more, if I'm kind, if I'm generous, if I do all of these things, maybe the adventure that I wanted will just like get back to where I need it to go. Or you look at somebody else's adventure and go, man, their adventure seems so much more awesome than my adventure. What's wrong with me? So you put your head down and you're trying to figure out all of these things. And to be honest, on our own, life can be a difficult adventure. Life can be a difficult adventure when you're trying to do this all on your own. But I've got good news for you and for me, that Jesus didn't mean for us to do this life on our own. In fact, Jesus invites us to something even better. Jesus actually invites us to his adventure. Now you may be thinking, wait a minute, Gene, I have my own plans for middle school. I know what middle school is supposed to be like. I know what I want to happen in middle school. I want to have good grades. I want to go join all the clubs and be a part of teams and do all this. It's like, Gene, I have a plan for what I want middle school to be like. But Jesus offers something better. He invites us to be a part of his adventure. And you're a part of that, and I'm a part of that. In fact, in John chapter 1, Jesus says, come and see. He also says to follow me. There's a dare in there. He's daring us to come and see what he's got for us. Come and see the amazing things I've got planned for you. Come and see what your life could be like if you just follow me. Jesus was all about a good dare. For those of you in here, some of you have already made that decision to come and see and follow Jesus, and it has been the best decision of your life. Now, some of you in here may not have made that decision yet, and that's totally okay. Because something else that I know to be true is that, like I said, we weren't meant to do this life on our own, except we were supposed to do this life together with the people around us. People who love us, people who will encourage us, people who will be there when it gets hard, people who will be there when things are really great and celebrate us, people like these guys.
We can't take much more of this.
We can't outrun this guy. We got to eject.
What?
We need altitude. Pull the ejection handles the second I tell you.
Beth, wait.
Booster, there's no other way. Eject, eject, eject. Rooster, pull the handle, eject!
It's not working!
I'm sorry, guys.
This is your savior speaking. Please fasten your seatbelts, return your tray tables till they're locked in upright positions, and prepare for landing.
You may not be going through anything tough right now, right here in this moment, but you will. Life will get complicated, life will be difficult, and you need people around you to help you on your adventure. Jesus wants to lead the way for you, but if you're not there yet, you've got people around you who want to walk alongside you on this journey. And so here in Transit, we have something called small groups, where you're put together with a group of other students just like you who may be going through the same things that you are, who maybe have the same questions as you are about life, about faith, about who God is. And in these small groups, this is a place where we want you to come and talk about anything. And when we say anything, we really do mean anything. I mean, a couple weeks ago, we literally were just in a relationship series. We want you to come and talk about all the things that you're experiencing on your adventure, because here in Transit, we believe that small groups are the best places for you to talk about your adventure. And so in just a few moments, you are gonna be able to experience a small group and what that is like, but I would love to pray for us this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for today, man. Thank you so much for Double Dog and all the awesome games and dares and things that we got to do yesterday, last night, and today. Heavenly Father, I just pray that you remind us that you are leading the way, that you invite us into your adventure, and give us the courage to step into that and to follow you. We love you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Y'all give it up for Gene one time for me.
Let's go.
Yes, that's amazing. I love that. You don't have to get up. We're not going anywhere. Yeah, I love that line that Jesus invites us into his adventure. That's amazing. I love that so much. So it was a great message.
That's fantastic. You know what that noise means?
That must have been it.
It's our final hieroglyph.
We got it.
That was the key.
We got it, but here's the thing. Does anybody read hieroglyph?
It's been a couple years. I took it in college.
I took it in college, but I didn't. Oh.
Here it is.
It's deciphering it for us.
Adventure.
Here it is.
You found it.
We got it.
I didn't think you would do it.
See ya.
No.
See ya, fellas.
Got it.
Maybe next time.
We beat it. Good job.
Well, y'all,
good job.
We did it. We beat it. Together, we figured out all of the challenges, got the hieroglyphs, got it deciphered, and now we are free to be able to head out. My first time students in the room, wherever you're at.
First timers.
If you come back next week, we have a special gift for you. You're not going to want to miss out on it, and you can pick it up right out there at the counter when you come next week if you're a first-time student. For all the rest of us, our adventure continues in our
small group.
You can head to small group, and we'll see
go
you
ahead and
back
head to
here
small group
next Sunday.
Let's go.